Today we'll discuss the difference between DMake and DMADB and DMADB's application example. Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. My last video showed how my client selected his new project. I've talked about DMake, which is a Lean Sigma project framework, in several of my videos. DMake is used for improvement projects for existing business operations. On the other hand, his new project is to establish a process that utilizes data for affiliated store sales, which is to make a completely new process. For this, we use DMADB rather than DMake. The first three phases of DMADB are the same as the DMake, which are define phase, measure phase, and analyze phase, but some contents are slightly different. The next DV will be design phase and verify phase. I will explain his project along the framework of DMADB. In the define phase, we define what kind of project we'll do. In fact, he made a project charter to define the purpose and goal of the project, listed all tasks of the project using WBS, and made a project schedule with the Gantt chart. In the measure phase, we collect VOCs, voice of customer, of the target process and convert them to new process CTQ, critical to quality, which achieves those VOCs. I made a video that explains the concept well. Please click the link above and watch it too. The customer of this process is my client himself, so his needs become VOC as it is. The starting point this time was I want to gather customer data and sales data in one place and generate useful information and tools for my sales force. An important KPI is simply to increase sales. Next is the analyze phase, but from this phase onward, it will differ greatly from DMake. In DMake, the main goal of the phase is to identify critical issues of the target process and find out their root cause. However, in DMADB, its main goal is to list more detailed functions for achieving the CTQ determined at the measure phase and decide basic design concepts. In DMake, we use the 5Y analysis and the Ishikawa diagram to find the root cause of the critical issues. In DMADB, CTQ is an object, and we want a solution for that. Therefore, we use the 5-How analysis to ask yourself or group, how, and how can we achieve the CTQ? Then we can think of many solution ideas and organize them on the Ishikawa diagram. This is the one we did. You can use it as a basic design concept. I'll be making another video about this exercise. So by following the basic design concept, we made the cyborg analysis and the value stream map for the new process, which became the blueprint of an Excel program we developed. In DMADB, the next phase is the design phase. Here, we are supposed to make more detailed design plan and complete the new process. In our project, it was all developed on Excel. We just used the Ishikawa diagram and the value stream map we made in previous phases as design plan. In the final phase, the verify phase, we verify that the new process completed in the design phase will properly fulfill the customer's needs. We'll also create a system that enables the operators to always work accurately in this process. In our project, we made an SOP, Standard Operating Procedure, in Excel. This time, I introduced DMADB, which is the guideline for developing a new business process flow. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.